Hi guys, welcome to this video. Today Fedora released their 32 beta release, so we're gonna have a look at this. It includes early OOM, so it kills hungry processes before they can cripple the operating system, so that's very nice. What else is new? Of course, the GNOME 3.36, so we'll get a few of that. What else? Some enhancement, the performance enhancements and that kind of stuff. So yeah, I downloaded it and we're gonna have a look at it. So close the window, restart Revert Manager. You can see I'm still on the KDE Neon, so I installed Revert Manager with OVMF on this machine. If you want to know how, I will. I have a video on my site where you can see how you install a virtual machine with OVMF. So let's start the installation of a new machine. So install local media forward. So we're gonna browse for the local media Fedora workstation beta. Forward. I'm gonna give it 4 gig of memory, 2 CPUs. 20 gig hard disk is fine. So let's call it Fedora 32. And I click customize before install because I want to do an EFI installation. So OVMF for EFI, apply, and we can begin the installation. We can close the virtual machine manager. I'm gonna go full screen and we're gonna select Fedora 32 beta. So this is on my test laptop. I installed everything as expected from KDE Neon. Everything via the software manager, via the software store. And until now, everything is working fine. In the previous distro shuffle I did, it was with Zorin. And OBS didn't work, and KDE Live had some crashes, and GIMP had some crashes. I must say on KDE Neon I didn't see any crashes, and as far as I can see OBS is working like a charm. Out of the box, no problems, we just installed it and yeah, everything seems to be working. So Fedora, install to hard drive. It's not the fastest machine, of course, but yeah, everything is working fine. Let's choose English, United States. That's fine. So you get a warning that this is a pre-release software. So do not use this for critical or work or production environments. Yes, I understand. So proceed. Then we select the disk. And you can do automatic, custom, or advanced custom. Let's just do it automatically, no problem at all. And we begin with the installation. So it's simple as that. I'll let this install and be back when we have a next session. So the installation has been done, so we can finish the installation now and we'll and then we have to manually restart. That's a bit weird, but it has to be done. So we restart the machine. Okay, let's go to full screen again. The first boot will always take a while. So I'll do a restart later and then check the memory usage and that kind of things. But let's first do a quick overview. And the strange thing is, the nice thing is with Fedora, it installs like it is an OEM install. So we didn't create any users yet to that kind of stuff. But that's going to be right now. So you get the welcome screen here. We click on next. Location services, I will put it off. Automatic problem reporting, so if you're especially when you're doing a beta testing or that kind of stuff, leave it on. So anything that you find will be automatically reported to Fedora so they can fix it for the official release. The online accounts, we can skip that. And we create the user. So you also have the enterprise login here. We put in the password, repeat the password, and we click on next, and we're all done. So start using Fedora. So we have a nice new wallpaper now. And we get the help for GNOME directly started. But let's first do something with the display settings. And make it a bit normal screen. Keep the changes. So you are greeted by the GNOME help. So how you launch applications, sweet task, use the Windows and workspaces and that kind of stuff. If you don't know it, very nice that they present it with you for you and you can start using it. So new nice wallpaper. You have the new layout of the application switcher here, or the setting switcher. In the middle we have the calendar with the new layout, with the new view. It's more like separated views. You also have to do not disturb here by default now, so that's nice. And if you go to activities, you have of course here your workspaces as default and all your normal default applications. If you go to show applications, you get all the applications installed. What else is new in GNOME 3.36 is the grouping. So you have new grouping, so where you can edit directly the name. And yeah, it's directly in the middle of your screen, so that's very nice. And when you click outside of it, it will go away. So what's installed by default? You have boxes, you have the calendar. That's a GNOME calendar, and so it's a complete view of the calendar. Yeah. We have cheese, we have clocks, context, files. So this is the default file manager Nautilus. It should also be the latest version, right? 3.36. You can adjust it by control and then your mouse wheel, or go to here and you can set it to minus or plus. You can show your hidden files here. You can open terminal on the right click. You can ask for properties. Advaita Lea, the icon set is very plain, but it's nice. It's if you look at the this icon set is pretty good. We have updates available, so you get to notify and you can see what updates are available. LibreOffice, Deja Do, Deja Vu, fonts, typing booster, and more core fonts, and some OS updates, modem manager, so all the new GCC, all the new versions for this kind of things. So it's quite a lot. I'm not going to do an installation now because we have to reboot. And it's gonna do a reboot and then install. So no, I'm not gonna do that now. We write files, so Firefox takes a while to load though. But we're getting there. Help about Firefox. So version 74. That's good. Close the tabs. And then we have the LibreOffice Calc, Impress, Math, and LibreOffice Writer. So let's see which version of LibreOffice we have installed. So we have 6.4. Very nice. Maps, photos, rhythm box, settings, of course, software store, text editor, the utilities, the archive manager, calculator, character map, disk uses analyzer, disks for it manages your disk, document scanner, document viewer, fonts, the help, image viewer, logs, screenshot utility, system monitor, and the terminal. We have videos and weather. So all the default applications are pretty simple. So yeah, if we go to the backgrounds, you have the new layout in GNOME 3.36, so you don't have to put it on your background in your lock screen and that kind of stuff. It will be automatically set by default. So this is a basic set of backgrounds. Of course, the gnomes have some nice ones like this one, or this one is very nice. So yeah, they have a couple of very nice ones. While we're here, we can go over the settings. So you have your network settings, of course, with your VPN or your network proxy. Bluetooth, if you have it. Backgrounds we already went through. Notifications, so you can set your notifications on or off for what kind of application you want to have your notifications. Your search, where do you want to search in? Your application settings per application, so you can set those. Your privacy settings, so what do you want to do with your camera? Do you want to enable the camera or not? Microphone. Thunderbolt, file and history, so do you want to clear it and that kind of stuff. Screen lock, do you want to have screen lock, turn off your screens. And diagnostics, automatic problem reporting, we already said that we have enabled it. Online accounts, so you have all the online accounts that you can imagine and you can add them. If you're sharing, so you want to do sharing, you can share your files, you can share your screen, you can share your media, or remote login. your sound settings, your power settings, your display we already saw, but we also have the nightlight here, so you can enable nightlight or not, sunset to sunrise or manual, your mouse and touchpad settings, keyboard shortcuts. So here are all your keyboard shortcuts, and I would add a couple of them and change a couple of them. Printers if you have some, removable media, your color settings for your display, region and language, that's pretty common, universal access, your users, your default applications, and here is something that I don't understand why they still haven't fixed it, your calendar is set to text editor. We have the GNOME calendar installed. So why is it a text editor and why can I not change it? So to me this is a puzzle. It's been like that in GNOME for a while now and I don't understand why. And especially in Fedora, every time I see it like this. So guys, please set it to the GNOME calendar because you installed it. Date and time, of course. And here is the about, so we're running GNOME 3.36 on Wayland, and we're running now in a virtual machine, and we have it on 4 gig of memory, 2 CPUs. So, basic overview of Fedora 32. If you have some spare hardware, install it for those guys, and if you just want to test it, want to go through it, and you have any issues, so report them, and we'll get a better stable release when it comes out as the official release of 32. No. So let's do a restart of the machine, and then we'll check the memory usage. And of course, which kernel version we're running. This always takes a while. But yeah, I want to have the EFI mode installer. Not sure what this is. It should be a splash screen or something like that. But it might be because we're running in a virtual machine. So here's also the new login screen from GNOME. So it's a bit different than it was before. A bit more modern. And if you have a photo or something like that, it will show your photo. So log in. There's one thing that I saw in the settings where of in the applications. As far as I know, there now have in GNOME a separate extension application. I didn't see that in the applications here. So if I go to all applications, there's no extension here. The extension applet or tool. What I saw in Ubuntu 20.04 already and that kind of stuff. So weird that it isn't in here yet. Tweaks is not installed by default. So I would install Tweaks and go to a dark theme. But those are the things that I would do. Let's go into a terminal. So we're now in the terminal, we do a memory check. So used 865 megabytes. Let's check that with top as well. Yeah, 845. So for an 836, for a clean boot, this is pretty nice. Control L, let me zoom in a bit because it's pretty small, right? So let's do that again, free. So 860 top, 841, and we'll go down. Yeah, and clear the screen, and then we do uname dash A. As you can see, it's running a very nice late kernel 5.6. And how long did it take to boot? It took 18 seconds to get the full boot. So yeah, pretty nice. If you have some spare hardware, check it. And leave your comments and remarks in the comments below. Also, if you have some OS that you would like me to see install and use for a week for the distro shuffle, let me know. And for now, guys, thanks for watching, and please like, comment, and subscribe, of course. And I will see you in the next one. Have fun with Linux, guys. Bye for now.